1995, when the internet started, Grateful Dead, one of the highest grossing rock and roll bands in the history of the world, over $50 million a year, primarily because of their sound, gave me a call and they said, "We think we want to do a webcast." And I said, "Webcast?" So I accepted the challenge of the webcast. So we called some friends we had at Silicon Graphics who were deadheads, and the people at Silicon Graphics said, "Oh yeah, we can help you with that webcast. We build the internet's best servers, and yeah, we'll set up. Well, let's go wire up a T1." We said, "Okay." So we went to the Fillmore in San Francisco, hooked up a T1, and we got all the AT&T people up there, and wired it up to our facility where we did mastering, and we were ready to go. And essentially, we clogged all of the internet pipelines worldwide. We took down Japan, which made the band members happy, actually. They said, "We took down Tokyo." Yeah. Unfortunately, while the broadcast was a huge success, the audio was absolutely terrible. So we had real-time chatter sending information, questions to the band members, and the band members were answering questions, and some of the information that came in was, "It's choppy and the stuff I can hear sounds really bad," and the band members saying, "We thought this was going to be audiophile quality," and I said, "So did I." But I knew I could do better, and I made a personal promise to myself that as a direct result of the horrendous sound of that first webcast, that I would figure out a way of making digital audio sound better. I started Sonic Focus on December 12, 1995 at that first webcast. Our first product was in 2001. So if I'd known it would take me 6 years to make audio sound better, I probably wouldn't have done it. So we came up with an idea of a new concept for Grateful Dead for a website, which would be a music-powered website. So we did webcasts, we already knew how to do those. Webcasting is a boring job. We had years of just sitting there for 6 and 8 hours listening to really incredibly bad audio that we're piping over the internet. So I said, "Okay, you guys are doing nothing. You're on the clock. Let's start working on this algorithm and let's ask the fans what they like. So bring in your best stuff. Let's hear it." So I got my engineers and scientists in, and I said, "Let's enhance the voice." "Okay, sounds good. Okay, get some chatters online. Let's let the people tell us what they like about Bob Weir's voice." And people would say, "Yeah, it sounds good, except I hear cymbals now louder." So we had this incredible focus group of fans that wanted to help because they love the stars, and they were talking to guys that were there with the stars. So we got the free focus group. We got a lot of feedback from the fans. The fans said, "Yeah, I really like that rip you did of this song, but you know, could you change it because the bass is a little funny?" So Alpine Valley 2002, Grateful Dead did a reunion. We had 113,000 simultaneous users of compressed audio listening in real time as the Dead tuned up, and then they went to an instrumental called "He's Gone." And so that webcast was presented in Sonic Focus fidelity, and that worked. We still had chatters telling us about it, but we only had a couple people. Mostly they had computer failure problems, not audio problems. We had people telling us that it's the best sounding webcast they'd ever heard on the internet. So that reunion show was hailed as a truly audiophile quality performance, and it was Sonic Focus powered. With Sonic Focus, you don't have to compromise. You get the portability that digital provides and the high audio quality that your customers demand. Don't take my word for it. Go and listen to the demo. Intel, Asus Tech, Samsung, Analog Devices, Hewlett Packard, and many others have licensed our products. We hope you will too. Thank you.